Welcome to the 8 best diabetes-fighting vitamins that also improve your heart health. Living with diabetes can be an incredibly challenging experience, but it's not only about improving your blood sugar. Were you aware that having diabetes can lead to atherosclerosis, or the buildup of plaque in the arteries? That can lead to major cardiovascular issues, including heart attacks and stroke. And chronic high blood sugar can lead to weight gain, putting even more pressure on your heart. On the flip side, cardiovascular damage can worsen your glucose control. It's a vicious cycle. But there's an often forgotten key for improving your relationship with your blood sugar and your heart, all at once. What is it? Naturally, it's vitamins. In fact, certain specific vitamins play crucial roles in blood sugar regulation, strengthening of your arteries, and overall health. But to get your vitamin fix, you don't have to worry about taking expensive supplements. We're about to reveal the 8 best diabetes-fighting, heart-helping vitamins, and the best natural foods which supply them. Before we dive into today's topic, could you do us a favor? Please hit the like button and make sure to subscribe to our channel to help spread the word about how to improve blood sugar control and heart health. Now, let's break down the 8 best diabetes-fighting vitamins that also improve your heart health. Coenzyme Q10. Unofficially known as vitamin Q10, this antioxidant compound is naturally produced by the body, but recently it has taken the health world by storm as a laboratory-synthesized supplement. Why? As it turns out, studies show that having low levels of coenzyme Q10 can increase the risk of both heart disease and diabetes. But results of multiple scientific trials involving over 2,000 diabetic participants found that getting proper amounts of CoQ10 may work to significantly reduce levels of fasting glucose, fasting insulin, HbA1c, and HOMA-IR, or homeostatic model assessment of insulin resistance. And some studies now suggest that CoQ10 may improve serum lipid profiles, meaning it can work to reduce levels of LDL cholesterol, the type of cholesterol associated with arterial plaque buildup, while increasing levels of HDL cholesterol, the type which works to purge harmful LDL cholesterol from the body. Research has also found that CoQ10 has the ability to reduce total cholesterol and may reduce high blood pressure as well. To get coenzyme Q10 via natural foods, try fatty fish like tuna and trout, legumes, including soybeans, lentils, and peanuts, nuts and seeds, broccoli, spinach, and even strawberries. What world-famous vitamin may secretly supply the added benefit of post-meal blood sugar control? That's just ahead. First, better put on your shades, because the future can be bright with vitamin D. This shiny vitamin, which you can get directly from the sun, aids the body in processing and retaining calcium, which works to strengthen bones. Vitamin D also makes muscles more sensitive to hormones, including insulin. By triggering insulin receptors, vitamin D increases the effectiveness of insulin, thus improving insulin sensitivity. Studies also suggest that vitamin D may support proper pancreatic function, which aids the secretion of insulin. Meanwhile, vitamin D is also involved in blood pressure regulation. In fact, research has found that being deficient in the sunshine vitamin can increase the risk of several cardiovascular issues, including heart attack, stroke, hypertension, and heart disease. But studies now show that vitamin D supplementation can work to reduce hypertension in those who already have high blood pressure and a vitamin D deficiency. And a study published in the journal Atherosclerosis noted that vitamin D supplementation helped decrease cardiovascular-related inflammatory markers in patients with coronary artery disease. To get your fix of vitamin D, just getting a little sunshine can go a long way. But to acquire more vitamin D from your diet, try fatty fish like salmon and tuna, cod liver oil, beef liver, vitamin D fortified milk, and eggs. Which vitamin plays a central role in glucose metabolism and also helps prevent anemia? That's coming up next. First, let's reacquaint ourselves with the power of vitamin C. This famous antioxidant isn't just for keeping colds at bay. Research has found that it can aid both your glucose regulation and your heart health. New studies have found that vitamin C may aid post-meal blood sugar control by slowing the glycemic response of high-carbohydrate meals. This can work to reduce the risk of a post-meal blood sugar spike. A recent study also found that vitamin C may help control levels of sorbitol, a type of carbohydrate which, in high levels, can lead to kidney damage and diabetic retinopathy. Additionally, vitamin C has been linked in research to increased insulin sensitivity and lower HbA1c levels, and importantly, for both improved glucose regulation and better heart health. Vitamin C has been shown to relax blood vessels and improve blood flow. In fact, a recent meta-analysis published in the journal Nutrients found that vitamin C supplementation led to a significant reduction in both systolic and diastolic blood pressure. Vitamin C does all this by improving the strength of the endothelium, the inner lining of blood vessels. In fact, an American Journal of Clinical Nutrition study found that type 2 diabetic participants who regularly consumed vitamin C supplements experienced significantly improved endothelial function. Plus, studies further show that vitamin C can protect against atherosclerosis by reducing the oxidation of artery-clogging LDL cholesterol. So, to improve your post-meal blood sugar levels and your blood vessel health, try citrus fruits, like lemons and oranges, the skin of palm fruits, including apples and pears, cruciferous vegetables, like broccoli, cabbage, and cauliflower, bell peppers, and even tomatoes. Guess the vitamin which has been found to significantly improve cardiovascular health for heart disease patients. That's coming up shortly. Now, it's time to meet vitamin B12, aka cobalamin. Cobalamin is renowned for its ability to aid nerve health and brain function, which, of course, is important for everyone, but especially for older diabetics who are at an increased risk of diabetic neuropathy and Alzheimer's disease. Vitamin B12 has been found to play a role in glucose metabolism by aiding the body in the conversion of glucose into energy. In fact, studies show that having a B12 deficiency can worsen the effects of diabetic neuropathy, and it may also lead to impaired insulin sensitivity. Meanwhile, B12 has also been found to help your heart. Have you heard of anemia? This condition is due to a lack of red blood cells, and it can lead to reduced blood flow. That may raise the risk of several medical complications, including stroke. But recent studies have shown that maintaining proper levels of cobalamin works to prevent certain types of anemia. And a big heart health benefit of cobalamin lies in its ability to positively impact lipid profiles. Studies show that vitamin B12 can work to decrease levels of blood vessel damaging LDL cholesterol, while increasing levels of artery aiding HDL cholesterol. Research also shows that vitamin B12 can help to remove excess homocysteine, an amino acid that, at elevated levels, can contribute to heart disease. Plus, research suggests that B12 supplementation may reduce levels of ADMA, a compound which, at high levels, can impair blood vessel function and speed the progression of atherosclerosis. So, to reduce your insulin resistance and your LDL cholesterol, get enough cobalamin via natural foods, including fatty fish like salmon and trout, grass-fed beef, lean white meat like chicken and turkey, eggs, unsweetened Greek yogurt, and even seaweed products like nori. Vitamin B3, aka niacin. Of the many benefits of this water-soluble antioxidant, niacin may be most famous for its ability to improve cholesterol levels. Studies have demonstrated that niacin can work to lower levels of harmful LDL cholesterol, while increasing levels of beneficial HDL cholesterol. In fact, a study published in the New England Journal of Medicine found that niacin therapy, when added to statin treatment, significantly reduced cardiovascular problems in heart disease patients. Other studies have found that niacin can also work to reduce harmful triglycerides, and it may work to lower blood pressure. Meanwhile, vitamin B3 has also been shown to improve glycemic control for type 2 diabetics. In fact, a Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism study revealed that overweight participants with impaired glucose tolerance experienced improved insulin sensitivity after supplementing their diets with niacin. And an American Journal of Clinical Nutrition study noted that niacin supplementation helped individuals with type 2 diabetes reduce their HbA1c levels. To get your daily dose of vitamin B3 via your diet, try cuts of white meat, like chicken breast and turkey, omega-3 rich seafood, like salmon, tuna, and anchovies, peanuts, mushrooms, and avocados. We're coming up on the top 3 vitamins that improve your heart health and blood sugar balance, all at the same time. What is today's number 1? That's just ahead. But first, let's focus in on vitamin B9, aka folate. This water-soluble vitamin has been found to aid the body in breaking down carbohydrates into glucose while reducing inflammation. This can work to decrease insulin resistance. In fact, a study published in the journal Diabetes Care found that folate supplementation worked to improve insulin sensitivity in type 2 diabetic participants. Folic acid is well known for lowering the risk of birth defects when taken by women during pregnancy, and it is also important for helping women prevent gestational diabetes, or erratic glucose levels that emerge during pregnancy. Scientists believe this is due to the ability of folate to increase the production of IGF-1, or insulin-like growth factor, a type of protein which has been found to aid blood sugar balance during pregnancy. Meanwhile, even if you aren't pregnant or a woman, folate can aid your heart health. In fact, research shows that those who are deficient in folate while having high levels of homocysteine are at an increased risk of cardiovascular issues, including stroke. But an American Medical Association meta-analysis found that folate supplementation can significantly lower levels of homocysteine, particularly for those with pre-existing heart conditions. And a 2016 study published in the journal Hypertension Research revealed that hypertensive patients who took folate experienced improved endothelial function, thus leading to a reduction in blood pressure. Plus, other research shows that higher intake of dietary folate is associated with a reduced risk of atherosclerosis in postmenopausal women. While you can certainly supplement your diet with folic acid, you can also acquire folate naturally. Try legumes, like chickpeas, lentils, and other beans. Leafy greens, like arugula, kale, and spinach. Nuts and seeds. Asparagus. Avocado. Brussels sprouts. Eggs. And even papaya. Ready to discover today's number one vitamin for aiding your heart health and your blood sugar balance? That's coming up next. But in your fight against diabetes and heart disease, don't forget to get enough vitamin E. Vitamin E's primary use is in battling external toxins that build up in our bodies. It is also well known for its anti-inflammatory properties, and it has been found to lower cancer-causing and heart-related oxidative stress. It has also been shown to support immune system health, skin health, eye health, and kidney function. Vitamin E also helps increase red blood cell count, which contributes to the oxygenation of blood, further promoting cardiovascular health. And importantly for those suffering from diabetes, studies show that vitamin E helps the liver and the kidneys in filtering and draining excess sugar out of the bloodstream. Multiple studies have further shown that including more vitamin E in your diet may lower HbA1c levels, fasting insulin levels, and HOMA-IR. But many doctors and dietitians believe that vitamin E can also be a powerful vitamin for improving your heart health. In fact, studies have shown that increasing your vitamin E intake may significantly lower your risk of coronary heart disease. Laboratory tests have shown that vitamin E can reduce the early stages of arterial plaque formation by preventing white blood cells from sticking to the cells which line artery walls. A study published in the journal Atherosclerosis further confirmed that vitamin E supplementation can improve endothelial function. And an American Journal of Clinical Nutrition study revealed that vitamin E may help reduce systolic blood pressure for individuals with hypertension. At the same time, other studies do suggest that taking too much vitamin E, especially in supplemental form, may have detrimental effects for your heart. Therefore, it's important to speak with your doctor before taking vitamin E supplements, and other vitamin supplements as well. But you shouldn't have to worry if you simply acquire vitamin E the natural way. So, get your daily dose of all-important vitamin E via nuts and seeds, including almonds, hazelnuts, and sunflower seeds, oily fish like salmon and trout, avocados, olives, sweet peppers, mangoes, and even kiwi fruit. Okay, it's time to reveal the amazing, multi-talented vitamin that can be perfect for improving your glucose control while lowering your risk of cardiovascular disease. Meet vitamin K. Vitamin K, a fat-soluble vitamin, is primarily recognized for its role in blood clotting, but it is also a key for reducing the risk of coronary artery disease. Vitamin K2, also called menaquinone, has been found to be particularly beneficial for arterial health, and studies show that it is associated with a reduction in arterial calcification. In fact, the Journal of Vascular Research found that postmenopausal women who took regular vitamin K2 supplementation experienced significant decreases in arterial stiffness, a key indicator of cardiovascular health. The study further noted that vitamin K helped prevent the accumulation of calcium in arterial walls. A separate study published in the journal Atherosclerosis revealed that increasing your dietary intake of vitamin K2 may reduce your risk of developing coronary artery disease. And other research notes that the antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties of vitamin K work to reduce oxidative stress in the cardiovascular system. Meanwhile, an American Journal of Clinical Nutrition study showed that increased dietary vitamin K intake was associated with improved insulin sensitivity in older adults. And a separate study published in the journal Diabetes Care found that type 2 diabetic participants who increased their vitamin K intake had notable decreases in their HbA1c levels. So, where should you go to get your vitamin K? Try spinach, broccoli, asparagus, cabbage, and even blueberries.